Dear students, today we will learn about the general characters of protozoa. Protozoa belongs to the kingdom Protista. All the protozoans are unicellular organisms. These are eukaryotic. Eukaryotic organisms are those organisms which contain definite nucleus. So all the protozoans, because of the presence of definite nucleus, they are regarded as eukaryotic animals, and they are included under the kingdom Protista. These protozoans are discovered by Antony von Leeuwenhoek, but Antony von Leeuwenhoek called the protozoans as wretched animalcules. Animalcules are those organisms which can't be seen with naked eye. As protozoans can't be seen with naked eye, Antony von Leeuwenhoek called them as animalcules, of course. But he called them as wretched animalcules because he felt that they don't have any significance. But later, it was found out that protozoans have got much significance and relevance to the human life because they cause many diseases in human communities. So protozoans are eukaryotic. Protozoans are first discovered by Antony von Leeuwenhoek, and Dobell called protozoans as acellular. Von Siebold called protozoans as unicellular. The entire body of protozoans is made up of a single cell, and the single cell of protozoans is equivalent to the entire body of multicellular organisms because it performs all the metabolic activities. So we can compare a single cell of protozoan to the entire body of an advanced multicellular animal. Body of protozoans is covered by either pellicle or plasma membrane, and protozoans have variety of locomotory organs. Some protozoans like amoeba moves with the help of pseudopodia. Some other protozoans move with the help of flagella, and some more protozoans move with the help of cilia. And some protozoans like plasmodium, they don't have any locomotory organs. Presence and absence of locomotory organs and the types of locomotory organs form the basis for the classification of protozoa. The protozoans that contain pseudopodia belong to rhizopoda. The protozoans that contain flagella belong to mastigophora. The protozoans that don't have any locomotory organs belong to sporozoa. The protozoans which have cilia belong to the ciliate. Ciliates are the most advanced protozoans, whereas flagellates are the most primitive protozoans, because the best example for flagellate is euglena. Euglena contains chlorophyll. As a result, we can say that it is a connecting link between plants and animals. Hence, flagellates are regarded as the most primitive protozoans. And coming to the various systems, protozoans, they are at protoplasmic grade of organization. It is very primitive grade of organization because of the presence of only single cell. Osmoregulation is nothing but the water balance. Osmoregulation is accomplished by one cell organelle called contractile vacuole. It exhibits certain pulsations. It contracts and expands. And these contractions and expansions are called systole and diastole. This contractile vacuole is also called water pulsating vesicle. Only freshwater protozoans will have a contractile vacuole, whereas marine and parasitic protozoans, they lack this contractile vacuole. If marine protozoan is transferred to fresh water, this marine protozoan will develop a contractile vacuole afresh. And excretion is done through general body surface, and the excretory product is ammonia. And we can say that all protozoans are ammonotelic. We know pretty well that ammonia requires much water for its elimination. It is water soluble. Because protozoans are aquatic in nature, they have opted for ammonia as an excretory product. And protozoans exhibit only fine responses, but these fine responses, paradoxically, they are very crude. They exhibit certain taxes. That means negative taxes or positive taxes. And coming to the reproduction. Reproduction in case of protozoans is both asexual and sexual. Asexual reproduction is performed in the form of binary fission and also in the form of multiple fission. If a single protozoan is divided into two pieces, two daughter individuals, it is called binary fission. Paramecium exhibits transverse binary fission, whereas Euglena exhibits longitudinal binary fission. Multiple fission is a mode of reproduction where the protozoan is simply divided into many daughter individuals. And protozoans also exhibit sexual reproduction. So we can say that sexual reproduction has made its appearance even at the level of protozoans itself. The mode of sexual reproduction in protozoans is conjugation. And protozoans have no natural death because their cytoplasm is not divided into somatoplasm and germplasm. Hence, we can say that protozoans are simply immortal. And study of protozoans is called protozoology. Let me sum up. Protozoans are included under protista. These are eukaryotic. They have got a definite nucleus, and this nucleus normally is single. Normally, protozoans contain single nucleus except ciliates, which exhibit nuclear dimorphism. Ciliates are the only protozoans which contain macronucleus and micronucleus. Body is covered by either plasma membrane or pellicle. Osmoregulation is performed by contractile vacuole. Respiration is through process of diffusion, and protozoans are ammonotelic. And reproduction is both sexual and asexual.